I very rarely, unless my schedule somehow doesn't allow for it, say no to an opportunity to talk to folks like you. Because there's something special about being around people who've been so generous and who are being so generous to our community. You know, I talked with a number of you beforehand. I know a few of you as well. And last time I checked, I don't think any one of you gets anything direct or tangible from this, right? In fact, I'm pretty confident that your involvement with the Sister Bay Historical Society probably cost you money, right? I mean, realistically, right? But you do it because you believe it. You do it because you love our community. You do it because you want our community to be stronger. And so a big part of what we do at the Community Foundation is just try to be around folks and encourage them to be generous and to thank them for their generosity, to thank them for all that they're doing for our community. You know, we've got a simple saying at the Door County Community Foundation, and some of you may have heard this before, but I think it bears repeating, in that it's really central realization that we had several years ago that guides a lot of what we do at the Door County Community Foundation. We believe that charity in Door County is more important to Door County than to any other community in Wisconsin. Now, I am not one usually for hyperbole. You know, it seems like, you know, especially if you watch the elections, right? This is the best candidate ever won, and that one's going to destroy America. This is the best we've ever had or the worst we've had. And the reality is most things in life are somewhere in the middle. But I actually think when it comes to the important role that charity plays in Door County, that it's not hyperbole. We're actually talking about the truth. Charity really is more important to this community than to any other county in Wisconsin. Now think for a moment about what you love most about this place. Maybe what you love is the incredible arts and culture and history that we celebrate. You know, you would love going to performances at Northern Sky Theater or going to shows at the Peninsula Players. You enjoy the big shows you can see at the Door Community Auditorium or the wonderful original plays in the Black Box at Third Avenue Playhouse. Maybe you enjoy the incredible arts programming we have. You can go to the school at the art school. You can go to the Link Gallery or the Hardy Gallery. Or perhaps you just love the fact that we honor and celebrate where we came from. And so we have wonderful places like this at the Sister Bay Historical Society and the Ephraim Historical Society and the Door County Historical Village at Crossroads. Well, guess what? Every one of these arts and culture and historic preservation organizations that are so important to the brand that is and makes our community strong, they're all charities. But maybe it's not the arts and culture that you love so much. Maybe you just love the fact that look outside and enjoy this incredible view. Enjoy the incredible verdant nature of our society. You know, you get to walk through the Ridges Sanctuary, which is one of the most biologically diverse places in Wisconsin, really. I learned that at Crossroads at Big Creek, which is an environmental education center. You know, we've got these incredible beautiful vistas that we preserve and protect through the work of the Door County Land Trust or the Nature Conservancy. And each and every one of these state parks and county parks that we love so much, well, they are the guardians of their work, the ones that extend and enhance so many of the facilities they offer. They're all friends groups, private charities, like the Friends of Peninsula State Park, the Friends of Pottawatomie Park, the Newport Wilderness Society. The guardians, the stewards, the champions, the advocates for our environmental treasures, they are all charities. But maybe it's not the environment that you love. Maybe just love the fact that this is a phenomenal place for the right kind of person. You know, if you want to go and want to play shuffleboard every Thursday afternoon at 4 and go to the play bridge with the same people at 2 o'clock, well, there are lots of places in much warmer climates that we could send you to with hundreds of thousands of other seniors that might want to make that their home. But those who choose to retire here are a different kind of retiree. They love the fact that we have a phenomenal educational system that makes programming available to older adults, whether it be things like the programs that we see at Bjorklund and that also go at Door Community Auditorium. You know, I'm amazed, for those of you who are here through the winter, you know, we have the clearing program that runs all summer long, but it's amazing to see people who continue to stay here through January and February and March to take part in the clearing winter classes in which the residents of our community teach one another. You know, we have an incredible ability here in terms of our recreational facilities for people who choose to retire here. We're Door County. We have 29,000 residents in January, right? And we have two phenomenal YMCA facilities. Imagine that, right? We've got a phenomenal medical system. How many places of this size have the facilities that we have with our medical center? And again, guess what? All of these things that we're talking about that provide us our quality of life, they're all charities. So the things that bring us here, whether they are tourists, whether they are people that choose to be here seasonally, or people who choose to retire here, the things that bring us here and keep us coming back year after year, overwhelmingly are tied to our world of charity. You know, this isn't Wisconsin Dells. I mean, think about it. The Dells used to be an environmental formation. Does anybody think of that anymore when it comes to Wisconsin? What do we think of water parks, right? We think of roller coaster rides and all those things. Charity has nothing to do with the economic survivability of Wisconsin Dells. You know, and they look at the number one tourist destination and visitor industry in the state of Wisconsin. You know where that is? It's Brown County. Guess what? It's the Green Bay Packers that draw them. But in our community, the things that bring us here and keep us coming back year after years, that provide us this unique brand that makes Door County so special, it's the charitable organizations of our community. So your gift to charity is not just a contribution. It's an investment in maintaining and enhancing and sustaining this remarkable quality of life that we all love and enjoy so much. But charity is more than just an economic development tool. Charity also helps alleviate some of the challenges that come from the unique nature of our seasonal economy. Now imagine, for example, the front desk clerk that works at a resort, let's say, in Fish Creek. Compare that same person in that same job to the one who works in Milwaukee or Chicago or St. Louis. In those other places, those are full-time, year-round positions. Here in Door County, they're working as many hours as they can for 4 or 5 months, then two or three months on the edges of the season, they're working part-time, and then that job disappears for 4 or 5 months out of the year. Imagine what stress that places on a family. So what do? We turn to the charities of our community to alleviate the challenges that come with the seasonal nature of our economy. We've got programs like Feed and Clothe My People and Lakeshore CAP that help fill the cupboard during winter when summer's wages are finally gone. But that person who works in those other communities, also because it's a full-time job and a year-round job, probably has benefits. They have retirement, perhaps, that they're earning. They're putting money away towards health insurance, which may be offered. Well, in our community, again, we have to turn to the charities to fill in where those jobs don't provide those things. So charity is more than an economic development tool. It also alleviates the challenges and the difficulties that families face in our community because of the seasonal nature of our community. So when we say that charity is more important to Door County than any other community in Wisconsin, we really mean it. It provides us our quality of life. It's the economic engine that drives our economy, and it alleviates the challenges that come from the seasonal nature of our community. Now, the good news is that the people of Door County are remarkably generous. And they're remarkably generous to a charitable sector, which is an enormous part of our economy. One of the most amazing things that we encountered, this is probably 5 or 6 years ago, at the Community Foundation, we decided to, without really knowing what we were going to find, but we said, we want to look at the IRS Form 990. That's sort of the tax return of the charitable world. So let's look at the IRS Form 990 of every charity in Door County, those forms. Let's see what they have to say. And one of the most amazing things that I found was the size of the charitable sector in our community. To give you an idea of its scope, if you added up the total annual revenue of every hotel, every motel, every bed and breakfast, and every resort, and added to that the total annual revenue of every restaurant, every diner, every food truck, And added to that, the total annual revenue of every bar and tavern, and that's a lot in those last two things. This is Wisconsin, after all. But you add up that total collective annual revenue of all those organizations, that's about the same size of the total annual revenue of the charities of Door County. It's about $110 million a year. That's how important charity is to our community. That's what it means for our community. It really is truly remarkable. Now, the good news is, when you look at that, the first reaction is, oh my goodness, what does that mean in terms of our ability to sustain and keep those organizations moving forward? Now, the good news is that we can afford it. There was a study done by the Donors Forum of Wisconsin that looked at the number of charities in our community and all across the state, and they looked at the wealth in varying communities. And they looked at how households have and what, you know, how much money they have. And the reality is, the good news is that Door County is the second wealthiest county in the state of Wisconsin on a household basis. Only Ozaukee County, outside of Milwaukee, has more per household wealth on average than we have in Door County. And I would argue that that number is underestimating the actual wealth of Door County. Because as those of you who work in my world of charity know, and those of you know who deal with the budget here at the Sister Bay Historical Society, a big part of that wealth comes, a big part of our charitable giving comes from seasonal residents. And that seasonal residents' wealth is not counted in Door County. It's going to be counted in Ozaukee County if that's where they live most of the year, or Florida, or wherever that might be. So when you look at the wealth of Door County, it is tremendous. Our ability to do great things, and you see it every day in terms of the amenities we have, is there because of the wealth of the people of our community. That's a wonderful thing. And the good part about it is we actually know for a fact how generous Door County is relative to other communities. There is a study that the Chronicle of Philanthropy, which is sort of the newspaper of my world, the nonprofit world that does, they looked at every 8 or 10 years, they pulled the aggregate data of 35 million tax returns in the United States. And they cross-referenced that with, and they've divided up by county. They get it by zip code from the IRS. And they can look and say, all right, 54234 in Sister Bay, here's what the average income is for somebody who lives in 54234. Then they subtract out of that number in 54234 the average cost of living. So what's the cost of a house? What's the cost of a car? What does it cost for groceries? What's your heating bill and your electric bill and all that stuff? So if you think about it, you know, in your own life, right? Here's my family's income. I take out of that income those required expenses that I have to pay, which are my household expenses. What's left is what we call discretionary income. What percentage of that discretionary income then is given to charity? Well, you go back to that tax return and you look at that in that community. The good news is you are sitting in the most generous county in the state of Wisconsin. The people of Door County, and I want to get sure I get the number right, the people of Door County contribute an average of 4.1% of their discretionary income to charity on an annual basis. Only Ozaukee comes close to that with 4%, and they're number two. In fact, when you compare us to places like Outagamie County, we're 28% more generous than Outagamie County residents. We're 32%, almost a third more generous than the residents of Brown County. It's a testament to the quality of the people who've chosen to make this home and their generosity they have to this place. People, though, occasionally ask me what it is that sort of drives this generosity in this community. Obviously the first part of it is, I think, what we talked about before, that we recognize and understand the connection between the remarkable quality of life that brings us here, that keeps us coming back year after year, and these organizations who help enhance and make this place so special. That drives a lot of our charitable giving. There's also, I think, another part of it that, you know, you always talk about community and that we have a sense of, I shouldn't say never been, but most places all think that they have some sense of community, and everybody does, right? But there's a sense and a spirit of community that's different about Door County that comes from, frankly, our small nature. You know, when you think about most places, people of different income demographics tend not to cross paths very often. Now, I have six children, I should say. My wife has six children, and I go to work all day. So, you know, we have six children. And in our six kids, you know, one of them played basketball. So we go to basketball games. And we'd sit there watching the game, you know, Sturgeon Bay playing Gibraltar, so we're sitting there in the gymnasium. And the guy on my left might live in the biggest house on Bayshore Drive in Sturgeon Bay. And the guy on the right, and this is actually a true story, the guy on the right lives in the dumpiest apartment you could find behind Walmart in Sturgeon Bay. But all of our kids go to the same school. You know, in lots of communities, that's simply not the case. Imagine how many places where we live behind walls. In fact, I remember going into Las Vegas, and you go, and one of the things about Las Vegas always amazed me, I did some work out there, was there are walled communities inside walled communities, right? Because, you know, you had to buy the $2 million house to get inside the inner wall, the outer wall, but we wouldn't let you in the inner wall unless you at least spent $10 million in the house, and there were like 20 houses in the inner wall. Right? That's how, excuse me, how so much of the world seems to be now, that we segregate ourselves out. You know, and it's not just if you have kids in the school. Imagine when you go to church on Sunday, whatever church it might be that you choose to go. When your pastor or preacher or minister or father or whatever you want to call them stands up there and talks to you about the lives of the less fortunate, it's very possible that one of them is sitting on the end of the same pew as you. When you go to the grocery store and you're going, I mean, realistically, we don't have a lot of choices, right, when it comes to the grocery store. We're going to go to the Pig. We're going to go to Main Street Market. Oh, my goodness. Karen Northam's my board. I better remember that. Main Street Market, forgive me. But, you know, but when you're going there, it's very possible to see somebody pulling out their AFD, what is it, what used to be the old food stamp program, but now it's on a card, right, that they use at there. You intersect with people of different income demographics that do not, that just doesn't occur in many other communities. And so in many ways, we have an understanding of an experience of people's lives in this community, which are not necessarily like our own. And in fact, I would argue that that drives our giving to a large degree. And in fact, there are statistics that prove that to be true. Because when you look at those numbers and say, what are what they call high income, high density communities? So a community in which the benchmark is $200,000 a year in annual income, where there's a huge percentage of the people who live in that zip code of that income, if compared to an income which has a more mixed demographic, the mixed income community gives at a rate at just more than 50% higher than the exclusively high income community. Now, I'm not saying that they're less generous human beings, because we're all, you know, they're good people, but the difference is that we just don't intersect. We don't see people who are different. We don't have an appreciation of there but for the grace of God go on. And that's what's so wonderful about Door County. And I think a lot of what drives our giving is to what we are and what makes us reality in being such a generous place. Now, every time I talk about giving, though, and I talk about how giving we are, one of the things I always get is sort of, oh, yeah, but, you know, donor fatigue, right? Donor fatigue. And it's, I'm tired of giving. And everybody's doing all these things. And I understand that sentiment in many ways, because when you think about what is fatigue, right? Fatigue is when you've carried a burden for too long. Well, the feeling of donor fatigue is not your fault as donors. And probably, realistically, it's not because you're being asked too often. It's because we in charity have failed. We have not made the connection for you between what you can do to help the community and the value of our work. We have failed to communicate to you the importance of the things we do. We have failed to give you an understanding of the worthiness of our work. We've failed to make you feel valued for your generosity, and we've failed to inspire you to be generous for the work that we do. And that is, in many ways, the great challenge. When you think about it, when you don't feel good about what you do, it becomes a burden. So charitable giving becomes a burden, and thus, like any burden, you become fatigued. So our challenge is to figure out how to reverse that trend. Right? You're about to undertake a pretty significant program. And I was looking at this wonderful thing, and I understand what this is. This is a document for your board of directors and for you as members, and that's terrific. And I look at this and I'm thinking to myself, you know, you're talking about that we have accumulated artifacts that we have to, that surpassed our ability to store them. We need additional display and storage space. We need workspace. We need archival storage space. That's all important stuff. It's really important to making what you do possible, right? But does anybody care, realistically? Does anybody care about more storage space? Or do you care about the fact that there's something that came, an artifact that was a part of our past that would otherwise fall apart and dispose of and destroy or otherwise not be preserved for the future? Do we care about the fact that we need more display space? Or do we care about the fact that we want an opportunity to share and tell the stories of those who came before us so that our children and our grandchildren will be able to appreciate all that we had before, the abundance we have now, so that we can help future generations understand where we came from? One of the great things that we fail to do in the world of charity, and I am the worst offender of it, is we forget the fact that we are all just tools. Money is a tool to accomplish a good. The Sister Bay Historical Society is a tool to accomplish a good. Building a new toilet space is a tool to accomplish some kind of good, right? But what is the good? You know, I would tell a story. I teach a class on fundraising that I do in Green Bay. I did one not too long ago. And I would tell the story of a lady who came into my office once when I worked for the Green Bay Foundation 20 years ago. And she came in, she slams her hand on my desk. I don't know why people feel like they can slam their hand on me, but she comes in and slams her hand on my desk. She goes, "Brett, we need $17,000. Well, yeah, don't we all, right? We need $17,000. All right. I said, why do we need $17,000? We need $17,000 because we have to pay Chuck's salary. Okay. I mean, I know who Chuck was. He made a really good pig roast once at the charity dinner in the park I went to. It was nice. Probably not worth $17,000. So, all right, well, what is Chuck, why is that important? Well, Chuck runs the Fatherhood Initiative. Okay, I'm a little interested now, but tell me more. What's the Fatherhood Initiative? The Fatherhood Initiative takes fathers and father figures and makes sure that they have an abundantly strong place in a child's life. Huh, all right, now I'm getting interested. Why is that important? Well, because we know that when a child has a strong father or a father figure in their life, they are more likely to graduate from high school. They are less likely to get involved in drugs. They are more likely to go on to post-secondary education. They are less likely to be involved in crime. Lots of good stuff gets better. Lots of bad stuff is mitigated when you have fathers or father figures in the life of a child. That is what people care about. Now, how are we going to accomplish that? Well, we're going to have a fatherhood initiative. We're going to pay Chuck's salary, and we need $17,000 to do it. And so your challenge as a historical society is to figure out how to articulate the tool that is that building, the tool that is the workspace and the archival storage, and remind people why it is that that's important. Why is it important that we should celebrate the charities, that celebrate the history and celebrate the heritage of this community? How does that make a difference in the lives of those that will follow us? How is telling the stories of those who came before us going to inspire those who will follow us? Figure out how to articulate that. Your challenge and question is not whether can our community afford yet another project or yet another capital campaign or yet another initiative. Your challenge is how can we talk about it in a way that makes people understand that it's not just a building. You're not preserving the buildings for the sake of being a building. You're preserving it to tell a story. And that story has a purpose. And that purpose is the one that we care about. Think about that. Articulate in that way, and you will be amazed at how many people will be inspired to join you. Because the good thing is, you're doing something wonderful. You're remembering where we came from. You know, it was 2 years ago, I lost my father. He was 9 days short of his 90th birthday. And, you know, I regret not having spent more time talking with him about where he came from. And he was his parents were from the Philippines and came to this country, couldn't read or write, never could in their entire life, never learned to read or write a word of English. And my father literally, at one point, they were so poor, literally lived in a cave. Actually went out to go find the cave once upon a time. It was in Hawaii where they were, that dusty Aloha shirt, right? And so the stories that I've captured in some of his writings that I've grabbed and I've collected, you know, are bits and pieces of things that he started on. But I never got a chance to really talk to him about it. And I came very late in his life. My dad, you know, I'm 46 years old. I wasn't even born when my dad was 46 years old. He was 47 when I was born, when I entered his life. And so I came very late in his life. But what that meant is my children didn't get to appreciate and understand where we came from. And how can we know where we want to go if we don't know what came before us to make us the kinds of people that we are? And that's what you're doing here, right? You're capturing the history of what made this community that we love so very much, so very special. And that's what we need to communicate. So when you show me a building, that's nice. That's wonderful. That's great, right? But it's a tool to accomplish a good. I'm less interested in the building. I'm more interested in the work you do. Because it reminds us of where we came from, and it preserves us for the future so that others will learn from it. And hopefully this will be here forevermore. So that said, thus endeth my soapbox for charitable giving for the day. I cannot tell you how much I appreciate the work you do, and I mean this sincerely. The reason that I come to talk to groups, big or small, and I was half joking when I said this early on, but the fact of the matter is that even if any of you happen to be paid, having worked in this world of charity before, you could be making far more doing other things. And the fact is, almost everyone here is volunteering, and in fact, your involvement here is costing you money. You are doing it not because of the building. You are doing it because of the way it makes you feel. I don't know how you feel. Some of us feel different ways. It's a different motivation for each of us. But it's that what makes it special. Remember, you got involved here not because you thought the building was neat, but because the building itself reminded you of something, told you a story, made you understand or appreciate some aspect of our community. That's why you are here. And so those of us at the Community Foundation want you to know how much we deeply appreciate all of your work, because we mean it when we say charity is more important to this community than any other county in Wisconsin. And frankly, we wouldn't be who we are were it not for the work of good people like you. So thank you all very much. Aww.